In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace and love of God our Father and communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My brothers and sisters, to prepare our hearts to enter into the sacred mysteries, let us together call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Gloria, 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 Señor. Gloria, 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 Dios. Gloria, 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 Señor. Gloria, gloria, gloria in Dios.
Gloria al Señor en lo alto del cielo. Gloria al Señor que por mí se ganó. Paz de la tierra a todos los hombres que gozan de la bondad de mi Dios.
Gloria, 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 Señor. Gloria, 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 Señor. Gloria, 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 Señor. Gloria, gloria, gloria de Dios.
Tú eres que quitas todo el pecado, eres Cordero de Dios celestial. Tú solo eres, Señor, eres santo. Tú solo eres Cristo Jesús.
Gloria, 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 Señor. Gloria, 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 Dios. Gloria, 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 Señor. Gloria, 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 Dios.
Tú eres mi Dios, santo eres yo, Hijo del Padre por la eternidad.
Gloria, 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 Señor. Gloria, 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 Dios. Gloria, 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 Señor. Gloria, 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 Dios.
Let us pray. Look upon us, O God, Creator and Ruler of all things, and that we may feel the working of your mercy, grant that we may serve you with all our heart, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. My dear brothers and sisters, today the readings will be proclaimed in Spanish, so you can use your English missalette if you need to follow along in English. And for the responsorial psalm, you can open up the page 211 in the Missal Dia for the responsorial psalm.
Del libro de Siráside. Cosas abominables son el rencor y la cólera. Sin embargo, el pecador se aferra a ellas. El Señor se vengará del vengativo y llevará rigurosa cuenta de sus pecados. Perdona la ofensa a tu prójimo, y así cuando pidas perdón, se te perdonarán tus pecados. Si un hombre le guarda rencor a otro, ¿le puede acaso pedir la salud al Señor? El que no tiene compasión de un semejante, ¿cómo pide perdón de sus pecados? Cuando el hombre que guarda rencor pide a Dios el perdón de sus pecados, ¿hallará quien interceda por él? Piensa en tu fin y deja de odiar. Piensa en la corrupción del sepulcro y guarda los mandamientos. Ten presente los mandamientos y no guardes rencor a tu prójimo. Recuerda la alianza del Altísimo y pasa por alto las ofensas. Palabra de Dios. El Señor es compasivo y misericordioso, lento a la ira y rico en clemencia.
Señor, lento a la ira y clemencia.
Bendice alma mía al Señor y todo mi ser a su santo nombre. Bendice alma mía al Señor y no olvide sus beneficios. El Señor es compasivo y misericordioso, lento a la ira y rico en clemencia. Él perdona todas tus culpas y cura todas tus enfermedades. Él rescata tu vida de la fosa y te colma de gracia y de ternura. El Señor es compasivo y misericordioso, lento a la ira y rico en clemencia. No está siempre acusando ni guarda rencor perpetuo. No nos trata como merecen nuestros pecados, ni nos pagan nuestras culpas. El Señor es compasivo y misericordioso, lento a la ira y rico en clemencia. Como se levanta el cielo sobre la tierra, se levanta su bondad sobre sus fieles. Como diste al oriente del ocaso, así aleja de nosotros nuestros delitos. El Señor es compasivo y misericordioso, lento a la ira y rico en clemencia. De la carta del apóstol San Pablo a los Romanos. Hermanos, ninguno de nosotros vive para sí mismo, ni muere para sí mismo. Si vivimos para el Señor, vivimos, y si morimos para el Señor, morimos. Por lo tanto, ya sea que estemos vivos o que hayamos muerto, somos del Señor, porque Cristo murió y resucitó para ser Señor de vivos y muertos. Palabra de Dios.
Lord, be in my heart, my lips, through the gospel of the Lord, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. El Señor esté con ustedes. Del Santo Evangelio según San Mateo. Gloria a ti, Señor. En aquel tiempo, Pedro se acercó a Jesús y le preguntó: si mi hermano me ofende, ¿cuántas veces tengo que perdonarlo? ¿Hasta siete veces? Jesús le contestó: no solo hasta siete, sino hasta 70 veces siete. Entonces Jesús les dijo: el reino de los cielos es semejante a un rey que quiso ajustar cuentas con sus servidores. El primero que le presentaron le debía muchos melones. ¿Cómo no tiene con qué pagar? El Señor mandó que lo verden a él, a su mujer, a sus hijos y todos sus prisiones para saldar la deuda. El servidor, dándose a sus pies, les suplicaba diciendo: ten paciencia conmigo y te lo pague todo. El rey tuvo lástima de aquel servidor, lo soltó y hasta el perdón de la deuda. Pero apenas había salido aquel servidor, se encontró con uno de sus compañeros que le debía poco dinero. Entonces lo agarró por el celo y casi lo estrangulaba mientras le decía: "Págame lo que me debes". El compañero se le arrodilló y le rogaba: "Ten paciencia conmigo y te lo pagaré todo". Pero el otro no quiso escucharlo, sino que fue y lo metió en la cárcel hasta que le pagara la deuda. Al ver lo que era, sus compañeros se hallaron de Gerasión, le fueron a contar al rey lo sucedido. Entonces el Señor lo amó y le dijo: "Siervo malvado, te perdón de todo aquel duelo porque me lo suplicaste. No debías tú también haber tenido compasión de tu compañero, como lo tuve compasión de ti". Y al Señor, y con desagrado lo entregó a los verdugos para que no lo soltaran hasta que pagara lo que debía. Pues los mismos harán mi Padre Celestial con ustedes si cada cual no perdona de corazón a sus hermanos. Palabra del Señor. Gloria a ti, Señor Jesús. Now, one of the things I will do when the readings are in the opposite language, I'll begin the reading. So today, being in Spanish, I'll begin my homily in English. Now, the good news is I have a short homily in both languages, so it's shorter than my other masses. So you get to be lucky that I have fewer words. So I had to be careful and precise because I want you to hang on to every word. Our first reading for today, my dear brothers and sisters, comes from the book of Sirach. Teaches that to be forgiven, one must forgive. In today's gospel from Matthew, Jesus tells the parable of the debtor who refuses to share with others the mercy he has been shown by his master. What did the master do after the debtor refused to show mercy? In his anger, his master handed him over to the torturers until he should pay back the whole debt. Our Lord then affirms the teaching from the first reading as he says, "So will my heavenly Father do to you unless each of you forgives your brother from your heart." Forgiveness is freeing. Forgiveness is healing. It is important to forgive even if the other party doesn't seek it. Why? Because if we harbor unforgiveness, there will always be a heavy weight that we carry. That is why our Lord is so emphatic about forgiveness. Yes, I know some of us have experienced such tremendous hurt that someone may have inflicted upon us, and that at times forgiveness is easier said than truly done. However, forgiveness is not impossible. Nothing is impossible for God. So how do we forgive 77 times? Or in other words, forgive always? The answer is let God in by experiencing for yourselves the love and the mercy of God. Go to confession frequently. If you are harboring anger, resentment, unforgiveness, approach the Lord perhaps monthly in that beautiful sacrament. There is tremendous grace in the sacrament of reconciliation. Sometimes we need to get out of the way, invite God in, and just let God do his thing. Now let's look briefly at the second reading. And by brief, I mean brief. St. Paul teaches that none of us lives or dies for oneself, but together for the Lord. We can learn so much wisdom from God. So today, put aside human wisdom and embrace the wisdom of God. If you want to be free, if you want to be healed, if you want to truly live, then forgive. Nuestra primera lectura de hoy del libro de Eclesiastio enseña para ser perdonado y que perdonar. En el Evangelio de hoy, según San Mateo, Jesús cuenta la parábola del deudor de que se niega a compartir con los damas la misericordia que le ha mostrado su amo. ¿Qué hizo el amo después de que el deudor se negó a mostrar misericordia? En su era, el amo lo entregó a los verdugos hasta que pagara toda la deuda. Nuestro Señor luego afirma la esencia de la primera lectura cuando dice: así hará mi Padre Celestial con vosotros, a menos que cada uno de vosotros perdone de corazón a su hermano. El perdón es liberado. El perdón es creativo. Es importante perdonar incluso si la otra parte no lo busca. ¿Por qué? Porque si abrigamos falta del perdón, siempre habrá un gran peso que veremos. Por eso nuestro Señor es tan enfático sobre el perdón. Sí, sé que algunos de nosotros hemos experimentado un dolor tremendo que alguien nos haya infligido y que hay ocasiones en que es más fácil decirlo que hacerlo. Sin embargo, el perdón no es impasible. Nada es impasible para Dios. Entonces, ¿cómo perdono 77 veces o otras palabras, perdono siempre? La respuesta es dejar entrar a Dios experimentado por ustedes mismos al amor y la misericordia de Dios. Confesaste con frecuencia. Si alberga ira, resentimiento o falta el perdón, adquírese al Señor, quizás mensualmente en ese sacramento. Y una gracia tremenda en el sacramento de la resurrección. A veces necesitamos quitarnos de camino, invitar a Dios y dejar que Dios haga lo suyo. Ahora vemos brevemente la segunda lectura. San Pablo enseña que ninguno de nosotros vive ni muere para sí mismo, sino juntos para el Señor. Podemos aprender mucho de la Señora a Dios. Así es hoy. Pero deja a uno lavado la sabiduría humana y abraza la sabiduría de Dios. Sí, quien es libre. Si quien eres ser sanado, que quieres vivir de verdad, entonces perdona. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen. Todos los días oramos para que Dios nos perdone nuestros pecados, así como estamos preparados para perdonar a nuestro prójimo. En nuestros entonces, busquemos la misericordia de Dios que perdona.
Por la Iglesia reconciliadora que trae curación a los penitentes, roguemos al Señor.
Te rogamos, óyenos.
For men and women skilled in the art of diplomacy to diffuse global tension, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Por aquellos que no pueden perdonar ni olvidar, roguemos al Señor.
Te rogamos, óyenos.
For sincerity in the sign of peace, we will give one another during the Mass. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Por los que están enfermos, para que sigan el consuelo, el amor y la paz de Cristo, roguemos al Señor.
Te rogamos, óyenos.
For those visiting our parish this weekend, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Por el perdón de los pecados de los que han muerto, roguemos al Señor. For the intention of the holy sacrifice of the Mass being offered for the people of the parish, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Padre bondadoso y misericordioso, lento para la ira y rico en compasión, concede nuestras peticiones por Cristo nuestro Señor. Amén.
Thank you.
Hola, ¿cómo estás? Bien, gracias. Muchas gracias. En el nombre del Padre, Hijo y Espíritu Santo. Amén. Gracias. Muchas gracias. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Look with favor on our supplications, O Lord, and in your kindness accept these your servants' offerings, that what each has offered to the honor of your name may serve the salvation of all, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For when your children were scattered afar by sin to the blood of your Son and the power of the Spirit, you gathered them again to yourself, that a people formed as one by the unity of the Trinity made the body of Christ in the temple of the Holy Spirit, might to the praise of your manifold wisdom be manifest as a church. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Santo, Santo, Santo es el Señor, Dios del universo. Santo, Santo, Santo es el Señor, Dios es el universo.
Dios está, es vida, 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 en gloria.
Dios está, es vida, 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 en gloria.
Hosanna, 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 en el cielo.
Hosanna,
Hosanna, Hosanna, en el cielo.
Bendito viene en el nombre del Señor.
Hosanna, Hosanna, en el cielo.
Hosanna,
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 Hosanna, en el cielo.
Turn. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Timothy, our Bishop, and all those who holding to the truth and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants. And all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you, for them we offer you the sacrifice of praise, or they offer for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glories of the Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, her blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers and all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands. With eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you are pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants who are those sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Dense for the mende la pax.
Cordero de Dios, que quitas el pecado del mundo, ten piedad de nosotros, ten piedad de nosotros. Cordero de Dios, Cordero de Dios, que quitas el pecado del mundo, ten piedad de nosotros, ten piedad de nosotros. Cordero de Dios, que quitas el pecado del mundo, dánanos la paz, dánanos.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ keep my soul safe for eternal life. May the blood of Christ keep my soul safe for eternal life.
Thank you.
Let us pray. May the working of this heavenly gift, O Lord, we pray, take possession of our minds and bodies, so that its effects and not our own desires may always prevail in us through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our announcements for the weekend. Save the date for the blessing of animals, which will take place on Sunday, October 1st at 1 p.m. in the parking lot outside here in the back. The event will be held rain or shine, because all I will do is simply stand inside my garage and you can drive up and do, and I'll do drive-by blessings. So just as simple, if it does happen, the rain. If not, I'll stand outside. I love animals, so. Also, next Sunday, we're having another Taco Sunday fundraiser. It will run from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. Reserve la fecha para la bendición de los animales que se llevará a cabo el domingo 1 de octubre a la 1 p.m. en la estacionamiento afuera aquí en la parte de atrás. El evento se llevará a cabo la buena o haga solo porque si mente estaré dentro a mi garce a traer bendiciones si es necesario. El próximo domingo tenemos otra reunión de fondos del domingo del taco, and that'll run from 9 to 15 horas. And also, if you're wondering how well we did on the turkey dinner today, it was fantastic. A great turnout again, with 620 meals sold, 40 turkeys donated, and the profit was over $5,400. So that was awesome. And so, and the thrift shop also did well today, so we did very well. So I want to keep you updated on that too. So, and I was very smart in this. You know, we had turkey today and taco this weekend, or next weekend. And the reason I think food 2 weekends in a row is a great idea, because Father O'Brien and I don't have a microwave right now, and probably won't have one until next week, so, or the following week. So it's good that we have 2 meals and back-to-back weekends. So I also want to thank Sister Marie, who printed out the ordinary of the Mass in both languages to make it a little bit simpler for us as we go through this week. This week, of course, Mass is in English, but next week, the order of the Mass will be in Spanish, and so you'll be able to follow along. I even like that I even have my own introduction here, so I don't have to hold the Missal. So it's very simple for me. So I want to thank Sister Marie for putting this together for us and to help us. So next week, the readings will be in English, and the order of the Mass will be in Spanish, and the hymns and the music will be in English. So to allow us all to participate differently each weekend and for us to learn. And don't worry if you don't understand something, because guess what? What we participate in is a mystery. And so not everything we can comprehend, and sometimes we just have to be still and be patient to allow God to work. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives. Thanks be to God. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in the day of battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray, and do that, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits